Cedar Crest kids, and welcome to another day of worship on this wonderfully rainy day that I'm filming on. Have you thanked God for something today? I think I'm going to thank Him for the rain.
Thank you. celebrating today. Welcome back to another week of Kids Worship online with Cedar Crest Bible Fellowship Church. And we are celebrating all day today. What are we celebrating? Well, you're going to find that out in a little bit. But let's play a game first. Are you ready for this? We're going to talk about some different celebrations that we have throughout the year. We're going to play a little clip of music for you, and you have to decide which celebration that clip of music is from. All right, are you ready? You can play against a family member, or you can just play yourself. Here we go. Here's our first song. You listen and see if you can remember or think what celebration this is from. Did you guess a birthday? Of course you did. Happy birthday to you. How many of you have birthdays in November? I see those hands. I don't really, but I know who has a birthday in November. Happy birthday to you guys. All right, here's the next song. Are you ready for it? Listen. What was that? Was it Christmas? It was Christmas. Are you excited for Christmas? We are not very far away. Have you written down your lists for your parents? I've been working on my list for Mr. Adams. Okay, let's listen to this song and try to think what kind of celebration this one's from.
L is for the way you look at me. Oh.
Ooh, that one was very romantical. Did you guess Valentine's Day? It was a love song for Valentine's Day. Okay, we're gonna have two more songs. So get your listening ears ready. Here's the first one.
God bless America, land that I love.
Oh, that was a patriotic song. What do we celebrate that's patriotic? Happens in the summer. Happens on the day 4 of the month of July, Independence Day, or July 4th. That was it. Okay, one last song. Are you ready? Here it goes. Well, that was the hardest one. We saved the hardest one for last. Did you catch it? That was an Irish song for St. Patrick's Day, which is in March, and I'm Irish, so we had to throw that one in there. Did you do a good job with that? Well, I hope so, because I love holidays, and I love celebrations. And that's what we're gonna talk about today as we talk about gratitude. So as we talk this whole month about our shout-outs of gratitude, we're defining what gratitude is. And here's our definition. Gratitude is letting others know you see how they have helped you. There's so many different ways that we can show gratitude to the people around us all the time. And what does our Bible verse say about showing gratitude to God? Well, we find that in Psalm 136:1. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his love endures forever. That's right. We're supposed to give thanks to God in every circumstance, remember from last week? And we can, because God is good, and his love endures forever. Now, I said in the beginning today that we're going to be celebrating. And what are we going to be celebrating? Well, we're going to talk about a man in the Bible who we've studied before, and his name is David. Do you remember David? Do you remember who David was back when he was a young man? What did he do for a living? He was a shepherd. That's right. He took care of sheep with his dad and his brothers. And when the prophet came to decide which one of the brothers was going to be king, who did he choose? Who did God tell him to choose? Right, David. Now, did David become king right away? Nope. There was a lot that happened between the time he was a shepherd boy and the time he became king, right? He went and fought Goliath and won. He had some run-ins with Saul, who was the present king of Israel. Do you remember that? And Saul's son, Jonathan, who was David's best friend. We've studied a lot about David, but eventually he did become king. And the story we're going to talk about today happened right after he became the king. We find our true story today in the book of 2 Samuel. Now, we already talked about how David had been a shepherd. God told him he would become the king of all of Israel. And he finally became king of God's people. And he had a wife, and her name was Michal. Now, even though David had finally become the king, something was still missing from Jerusalem. The Ark. Now, the Ark didn't look exactly like this, obviously, but this is the best we could do. When I say Ark, I'm not talking about a giant boat holding lots of different animals. The Ark I'm talking about is the Ark of the Covenant. It was a wooden chest covered in gold, and the stone tablets of the Ten Commandments and other special objects were inside. In some special way, the Ark carried God's very presence among the Israelites. When they had the Ark, they knew that God was with them. At this point, the Ark had been captured by the Philistines and then returned to God's people. It was sitting in the home of a man named Obed-Edom. David wanted the Ark brought back to Jerusalem, and he wanted to set up a tent for the Ark too. David was excited about his plan. Look at those excited faces and excited moves that David's making. But it seems that his wife Michal was less than enthusiastic. Michal might have looked a little bit like this. But David put his plan into action with great joy. He built a big tent where the Ark would go. Then he gathered his best soldiers and marched to the place where the Ark rested. His soldiers lifted the Ark with carrying poles, like God had told them to. He gave them specific instructions not to touch the Ark with their hands. And they began carrying it back to Jerusalem in that special way. The soldiers began to move the Ark, but after only 6 steps, David stopped them. King David was thankful, so he made a sacrifice to honor God. He got down on his knees and prayed, and after David finished with the sacrifice, he and his soldiers resumed their trek back to Jerusalem. But as they continued walking, David didn't just walk, he danced. In fact, he danced for God with all his might. Woo, David! As they drew closer to the holy city, David continued to dance joyfully for God. Everyone who had gathered in the city helped him bring the Ark into the tent. That means everyone jumped in to help. They got the Ark under the tent, and the people shouted and they blew trumpets. Oh my goodness, what a celebration! But not everyone was having a good time. David's wife, Michal, was watching from a window. She was upset because David wasn't wearing his royal robes. He was hanging out with the common people, and he wasn't walking with his head held high like a king. He was dancing. That's right. He was still dancing, and everyone else is dancing too. Michal thought David looked ridiculous. Ugh, she was shocked and annoyed. David continued to dance all the way to the tent that he had set up. He made more sacrifices to honor God, and then he blessed everyone who was there. He gave them food to celebrate, loaves of bread, date cakes, and raisin cakes. Eventually, everyone headed home. When David returned home, Michal was furious. She told David that he had made a fool of himself by dancing. Listen to what David said to her in return. We find this in 2 Samuel, verse 21 of chapter 6. "I did it to honor the Lord," David said. "The Lord appointed me ruler over his people Israel. I will celebrate to honor the Lord." In fact, you know what else David said? He had said that he would bring even less honor to himself if it would bring more honor to God. Wow, David, Michael, thanks for your help. You've been awesome. Michael and David cared about different things. Michael cared more about what others thought and what things looked like, while David cared more about how things really were and about celebrating God and all that God had done. He was so happy that the Ark of the Covenant was finally back where it should be that he celebrated with abandon, which means he just let loose and celebrated God and all that God had done. And we also have so much to celebrate. And that's our bottom line for today. Celebrate what God has done. What are the things in your life that God has done for you that you can celebrate? Let's start by praying and thanking God for all he's done for us. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the great example of David and how he just loved celebrating you. He didn't care if he looked silly. He didn't care what other people thought. He cared about you and honoring you and giving you a big shout out of praise and dancing for your honor and your glory because of all the amazing things that you have done. God, we celebrate you today and all the things that you've done in our lives. You are an awesome God, and we love you so much, and we are so thankful, so grateful for all you've done for us. In the hard times, in the good times, you are always good, God, and we celebrate your name today. In Jesus' name, amen. How are you going to celebrate God today? I would love to hear if your family decides to maybe have a celebrating dance party with some good praise music, or maybe you want to get back out your list from last week of the things you have to be grateful for, and maybe write a letter to some of the people on there of gratefulness that you have to them and celebrate those people. I would love to hear what you decide to do, but whatever you do, make sure to give God the glory and the thanks because he deserves it and we should be celebrating him. Next week, come on back and we'll talk more about gratefulness and all that we have in our lives to be thankful for. I love you guys and I miss you. Have a great week.